For this tutorial, you need 5 different colors of yarn, a button, needle, a scissor, and I use a crochet hook of 3.5 mm. Let's get started! I start with the first color to make this little heart here of the back. Make a magic circle on the hook. And in that magic circle we start with a first 2 double crochet together. And this first double crochet together is a little bit different than the rest of the 2 double crochets together. We start with a chain 2. It's 1 and 2. Yarn over. Go in that magic circle. Grab your yarn. Pull up. Yarn over. Pull through 2. Yarn over. Pull through 2. This counts for a first 2 double crochet together. Make a chain 2. 1 and 2. And now in the back in that magic circle we make 2 double crochet together. Yarn over, enter your hook in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, go back in that same circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 2. Now you have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops in one go. And then make a chain 2. And this 2 double crochet together and that chain 2, we repeat this 4 more times. In the magic circle, 2 double crochet together. That's 1. And 2. 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, work together, and then make a chain 2. That's 3 groups, 3 to go, 2 double crochet together in a magic circle, then a chain 2, again in the magic circle, 2 double crochet together, and a chain 2. And for a last time, 2 double crochet together in the magic circle. Then a chain 2. Now pull on the short tilly in the middle to close the magic circle. And make on the top of the first 2 double crochet together. That's on the top of the first real double crochet. Go in with your hook under to that V-stitch. And make a slip stitch. Yarn over, pull through and pull through. Now cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. The second color. We make a slip knot on the hook. And then we begin in a chain 2 space with a standing 2 double crochet together. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in a chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 2. Yarn over, enter your hook back in that same chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 2. 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the 3 loops on the hook. This is your first standing 2 double crochet together. Now make a chain 3. It's 1, 2 and 3. Now go back in that same chain 2 space with another 2 double crochet together. Yarn over, enter your hook in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, back in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and work together. This little repeat, we repeat this 5 more times. Skip over to the next chain 2 space and make 2 double crochet together in that space. That's 1 and 2, yarn over, work together. Then in chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, back in that same chain 2 space with another 2 double crochet together. That's 1, that's 2, yarn over, work together. 2 repeats complete. We repeat these stitches 4 more times, all the way around, and then we make a slip stitch here on the top of the first 2 double crochet together. I'm all the way around, make a slip stitch on the top of the first 2 double crochet together, under through that V stitch here on the top, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. Make a slip knot on the hook with the third color. And now we make all these shells. We begin with a first standing double crochet in a chain 3 space. Yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter hook in a chain 3 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. This is a standing double crochet. In that same space, 6 more double crochets. That's 7 in total. That's 1. Back in that same chain 3 space. That's 2. Three, four, five, six, and 7 double crochets for our first shell. Now we skip over the next 2 times 2 double crochet together, and then we go here in the next space of the 3 chain stitches. And make also 7 double crochets in that same space. Yarn over into that next chain 3 space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Repeat all these stitches of a shell of 7 double crochets 4 more times. Then make a slip stitch here on the top of the first standing double crochet, cut the yarn and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. The next color is on the hook with a slip knot, and we begin on the top of a first double crochet of a shell. This double crochet here with a standing double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter hook in that first double crochet of a shell and make a double crochet. Into the next stitch, that's the second double crochet of that shell, make 1 half double crochet. Yarn over, enter hook in the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops. That's a half double crochet. Now in the next 3 stitches, make 1 single crochet. That's 1, into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, and into the next stitch. That's 3 single crochets. Into the next stitch, 1 half double crochet. And in the next stitch, a double crochet. Now we make a treble over this round here, the previous round, and then 1 row below here between the 2 times 2 double crochet together. Not on the stitch, not on that stitch here, but between those 2 stitches. Yarn over twice for a treble. Now go to round 2 you in this space here. Then grab on the back your yarn and pull a loop and make that loop a little bit longer. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. And these stitches, we repeat those stitches 5 more times. I'll show you the repeat once more. Into the next stitch, and that must be on the top of the first double crochet of that shell, and double crochet in that stitch. In the next stitch, 1 half double crochet. In the next 3 stitches, a single crochet, that's 1, 2, and 3. In the next stitch, a half double crochet. In the next stitch, 1 double crochet. And then we make a treble, yarn twice over, then go to round 2 between the 2 times 2 double crochet together, between those stitches. Grab your yarn, pull a loop, make that loop a little bit longer. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. Repeat 4 more times. Make a slip stitch on the top of the first standing double crochet. Cut the yarn and weave the tails in. Next colors on the hook. And now we start with a standing half double crochet in a stitch. It doesn't matter which one you choose one. Yarn over and the hook in a stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 3 loops on the hook for a first half double crochet. Now back in that same stitch, make another half double crochet. Yarn over, back in that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through 3 loops. Now you have here 2 half double crochets in that same stitch. In the next 3 stitches, 1 half double crochet. In the next stitch, half double crochet, that's number 1. Into the next stitch, that's 2. Into the next stitch, that's number 3. And this is also the repeat you work all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochets in that same stitch. Then in the next 3 stitches, 1 half double crochet. That's 2 and that's 3. Work like this all the way around. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochets in that same stitch and then 3 times 1 half double crochet. My last repeat, 2 half double crochets in that same stitch and then in the last 3 stitches 1 half double crochet. That's 1, 2 and 3. Then we make a slip stitch here on the top of the first standing half double crochet. Yarn over, pull through and pull through. Cut the yarn and weave the tails in. Now you have all the way around 60 stitches in total. The front of the little bag is complete. Now we start on the back side. And we choose 1 color. For me is that a light blue color. And we make a slip knot on the hook, but make that tail here in the begin a little bit longer so we can attach that button here later on. Make a magic circle. And then we start with a first double crochet and that's a chain 3. It's 1, 2 and 3. Now in the magic circle make 11 double crochets all in that same circle. Yarn over and the hook in that circle, grab on yarn and make a double crochet. Now we have here 2 double crochets. It must be 12 in total. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, 11, and 12. Now pull on that tail of the magic circle to close, and then we make on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch, 1, 2, and 3. There we make a slip stitch. Round 2 with the same color, and we begin with the first double crochet, that's in chain 3. Now back in that same stitch where you make in the previous one, that slip stitch, make 1 double crochet in that same stitch. Now you have 2 double crochets in that same stitch. Skip over to the next stitch. In that stitch also 2 double crochets in that same stitch. And this is the repeat you work all the way around. Into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. Work like this all the way around till you have 24 double crochets in total. In each stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch. I'm all the way around, 24 double crochets in total, that's including that chain 3 counts for a first double crochet, and on the top of that first double crochet, in the third chain stitch, we make a slip stitch. Round 3, and we start with in chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Back in that same stitch with another double crochet. So you have 2 double crochets in that same stitch. Into the next stitch, make 1 double crochet. The repeat of this round. Into the next stitch. 2 double crochets in that same stitch, that's 1 and 2, and then in the next stitch 1 double crochet, and this is the repeat you work all the way around. The next repeat is 2 double crochets in the next stitch, that same stitch, so 1 and 2, and then in the next stitch 1 double crochet. Work like this all the way around and make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet. The next round, we start with a chain 3, count for a first double crochet, and now back in that same stitch make another double crochet. 2 double crochets in that same stitch, and then into the next stitch make 1 double crochet. The repeat of this round is the same that we did on the last round. Into the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch, so 1 and 2, and then into the next stitch only 1 double crochet. In the next stitch, 2 double crochets in that same stitch, in the next stitch 1 double crochet. Work like this all the way around and make a slip stitch on the top of the first chain 3. That's the first double crochet. We start on the last round. In this round we make half double crochets. Your first half double crochet is in chain 2. It's one and two. Now go back in that same stitch with another half double crochet. So we have two half double crochets in the first same stitch. Into the next 8 stitches, one half double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochets in that same stitch. That's 1 and 2. And then into the next 8 stitches, 1 half double crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And this is to repeat your work all the way around. Into the next stitch, 2 half double crochets in the same stitch, and then in the next 8 stitches, 1 half double crochets all the way around. And then in beginning, we make an invisible join to close this round. I'm all the way around with all my stitches, and now you must be have 60 half double crochets in total. That's including that chain 2 here in the beginning. You make an invisible join. Cut the yarn. And now we open up that stitch. Pull your hook all the way up. And now we grab a needle. The thread goes through that needle to make an invisible join. We skip always the first stitch. That's the first half double crochet. That's here, that chain 2. We skip those 2 chain 2 stitches and we go to the real first half double crochet. On the top of that half double crochet, you undo through that V stitch on the top. Go through with your needle and then pull through. Then back to the last half double crochet. You're on the top, you see also that V stitch. Now pull that needle through the top, only in the back loop of that stitch. And then pull through. And now this V stitch here, that's the invisible join. Turn your work, and then on the back, I go with the needle under through a little thread here. Then pull through, not too tight, you must see that invisible join. And go through, under through that same thread here for a second time. Now make a little loop. Pull that needle not through and through, only like this, and then we have here a little loop. Go with your needle into that loop and then pull. Then you have a little knot. Now wave that tail in on the back of the stitches. You do not see that needle on the front. Now we skip here on the back one little piece of thread and go back to the other side. Now you can cut off that yarn. Now you in the middle pull that tail to close that magic circle. Then with that same needle, that goes to that needle. You make also a little knot here on the back. Go on through a little stitch. Then pull through for a second time under through that same stitch. I'll make a little loop. Then the needles go through the loop and then pull. Now we turn our work and now we look at to the good side of the stitches. Now we place that button here in the middle and weave that through and through on the back of that little bag. Then a few more stitches, then make a little knot on the back and weave that tail also in. Now we have a front and a back. And we start on the back side of the bag. I made a slip knot on the hook with an other color blue. Now here on the top of that button, in that stitch, we count 7 stitches back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In that stitch, go in with your hook and make 1 single crochet. And that's a standing single crochet. Grab your yarn, pull up, up, yarn over, and pull through 2. Into the next 13 stitches, you make also 1 single crochet. That's 14 single crochets in total. This is the first, into the next stitch. That's 2, in the next, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14 single crochets. Now we place that front of the back on the back side of here, that little back here, and we turn our work and now we're facing at the wrong side of the stitches. Place this back side on the front and now we work in every stitch through and through a single crochet. This is the stitch where you're working in and then into the next stitch and in a stitch here on the back under through both V-stitches. Grab your yarn, pull a loop, yarn over, pull through 2. Into the next stitch and into the next stitch, yarn over, pull a loop, yarn over, pull through 2. And this is the way how we work all the way around till we get at the point here in the beginning. That's the last stitch that you work through and through to 2 pieces of your work. Work like this. And I see you here in the beginning where we make only single crochets on this part here. 2 more stitches to go. And this is the last stitch. In the next stitch, there's the standing single crochet. It's 1 stitch to go. And now make on the top of the first standing single crochet a slip stitch. So we all the way around. Now you work here on the front of the stitches through the back of the next stitch where we're not working in yet. We work in the next 7 stitches also 1 single crochet. That's 1. The next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now we have the 7 stitches left over. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 here in the beginning. Now we make a little loop of chain stitches around that button here. It depends how big your nut of big your button is. So we make chain stitches like this. Work those chain stitches not too tight. Then see how far you go. Go around that button. A few more stitches. Let's see how far we are. Go around that button. Maybe one or two chain stitches more. Let's see. Yes, that's enough. So then go with the needle through the next stitch and make in the next 7 stitches also one single crochet. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and in the last stitch number 7. Now we cut the yarn and weave the tilje in the back, and that's the inside of the stitches in the inside of the back here. Weave that tail in and then you're done. And your little bag is complete. Lots of fun to create your own little bag. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!